You're watching a production of South Dakota Public Broadcasting. This high school activities championship event is conducted under the auspices of the South Dakota High School Activities Association.
And good afternoon and welcome to the Premier Center in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. It is the state boys AA basketball tournament for the next 3 days here on SDPB1. So delighted to have you joining us with Craig Maddock from Sioux Falls Sports Radio, KWSN. I'm Mike Henriksen from SportsMax Radio and Calling All Sports. Craig, we got the opportunity last year on SDPB1 to close the old Sioux Falls Arena. This year we get the opportunity to open the brand new Premier Center.
And this is going to be kind of the last of an era this year too, Mike, because a year from now it'll be a combined AA boys and girls basketball tournament.
Yes, they will be in the same location at the same weekend, and we'll be talking about that throughout the course of this weekend as well. Coming up today, it is the number 8 seed and the number 1 seed. Huron takes on Sioux Falls, Washington. And then in our second game today, Rapid City Stevens will take on Aberdeen Central. Craig, let's take a look at this. And then this evening, Sioux Falls Lincoln takes on Watertown. And our nightcap is Sioux Falls O'Gorman taking on the Peer Governors. Let's take a look at our first game this afternoon, Craig. You have Sioux Falls, Washington, who has been right at the top of the rankings all season long, but Huron comes in. They've been relatively hot recently.
They win their two games in the district, and they get that automatic trip to the AA tournament. Their 50th appearance in the history of the Tigers. There you see they go on the road to beat Aberdeen. And then they did lose to Peer, but then went out to Sturgis. Tell you what, a lot of folks thought Sturgis would be at this state tournament. And so they get the number 8 seed. Coach Button Hagen, this is the 4th straight appearance for Huron. The 11 titles in its history. It's a team that will rely a lot on some guard play with Houston Hines, Hayden Bush. There's your starting lineup.
And again, 2 seniors and 3 juniors. Houston Hines, Trey Moding, Hayden Bush, Sam Carr, and Peyton Carr are your starters for the Huron Tigers. Meanwhile, for Sioux Falls, Washington, Craig, located on the east side of Sioux Falls, they have really been pretty much the favorite for much of this year.
Well, Sioux Falls, Washington, they're 20-2 on the year. 69th appearance for the Warriors, their 2nd straight. And for Washington, they have not lost to a team in South Dakota. Their only losses, one was to De La Salle, which won the boys' state championship in Minnesota last week. And the other one was to Marshall, and Marshall hits a 3-point shot of 3/4 the length of the court at the buzzer to beat them. But still, a very strong Sioux Falls Washington club. They beat Brandon Valley, and then beat Lincoln for the 3rd time this year in another close game.
And so it will be Sioux Falls, Washington. Let's take a look at their starting lineup for you, as they've got a couple of bigs inside. Sam Saganos is an outstanding point guard. Carter Keller, the junior. Ty Smith, one of the guards. But the two big men inside, Deng Gu, 6'8", and a senior, and Cole Benson, 6'7", and a senior. Inside is where Washington really likes to key things in, and they're excellent at kicking those shots or the pass outside to the guards.
Gu and Benson, the leading scorers for the Warriors.
And Cole Benson has been an interesting story, Craig. We'll talk more about it during the game. But this is a kid who spent most of his junior high career in a wheelchair. He's essentially had both knees replaced. not with artificial knees, but with natural knees. It's quite the story to see him be where he is. And so we are set to go with our opening festivities from the Denny Sanford Premier Center.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Sioux Falls and the Denny Sanford Premier Center. The South Dakota High School Activities Association, along with its corporate partners, Sanford Health, First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card, Farmers Union Insurance Agency, Billion Automotive, and the South Dakota Army National Guard, welcome you to this opening session of the State AA Boys High School Basketball Tournament. This tournament is being conducted under the guidance and regulation of the South Dakota High School Activities Association for the enjoyment and benefit of high school students. Good sportsmanship is essential for the success of these programs. We hope you will enjoy the games and support your athletes in a positive and sportsmanlike manner. Be a sport and support good sportsmanship. Now, ladies and gentlemen, would you please stand as we honor America? Join in singing our national anthem, and it is sung by a Sioux Falls Lincoln High School choir under the direction of Linda Conrad. We would remind all in attendance that the proper respect is to remove your hat, face the flag, and stand at attention with your right hand over your heart. Veterans in active duty military not in uniform may salute the flag. Ladies and gentlemen, our national anthem. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this opening round game of the State AA Boys Basketball Tournament, featuring the Tigers from Huron and the Warriors from Sioux Falls, Washington. Ladies and gentlemen, before we meet our teams, let's meet the cheerleaders. Beginning with the cheerleaders from the Huron Tigers. They are Taylor Ringy, Alyssa Bird, Kinsey Evans, Madeline Kranzler, Kelly Neas, Jennifer Nelson, Taryn Kistner, and the mascot is Brandon Haber. Cheer coach is Whitney Easton. And let's meet the cheerleaders from the Washington Warriors. Cody Cook, Kiera Harkema, Mackenzie Helwig, Lexi Jansma, Kendall McMahon, and Alexis Paulson. Cheer coaches are Alicia Baus and Cindy Jones. Now let's meet the participants, beginning with the Huron Tigers. Team members include number 12, Highland Heinz. Number 22, Mason Staley. Number 24, Carter Brotherton. Number 30, Greg Conrad. Number 32, Riley Galen. Number 34, Clay Corco. Number 40, Ty Evers. Number 50, Cole Corco. Number 52, Alex Jimenez. And number 54, Brendan Cohen. And let's meet the team members from Washington. Number 5, Jacob Johnson. Number 10, Quinton Johnson. Number 12, Jacob Skokstead. Number 14, Jack Talley. Number 22, Robert Speaks Jr. Number 24, Logan Utek. Number 40, Alipo Oliak. Number 42, Isaac Goman. Number 44, Sam Gazine. And number 54, Max Farniak. Now, let's meet our starting lineups. Introduced alternately and beginning with the Tigers from Huron. At a guard, a 5'11" senior, number 10, Houston Hines. And for the Washington Warriors, at a guard, a 6'1" junior, number 4, Sam Siganos. At a guard for the Tigers, a 5'11" junior, number 14, Trey Modig. And at a guard for the Washington Warriors, a 6'3" junior, number 20, Carter Keller. At a guard for the Huron Tigers, a 6'1" junior, number 20, Sam Carr. And at a guard for the Warriors, a 6'3" junior, number 30, Ty Smith. At a forward for the Tigers, a 6'5" junior, number 42, Peyton Carr. And at a forward for the Warriors, a 6'8" senior, number 32, Dang Goo. And starting at a guard for the Tigers, a 6'3" senior, number 44, Hayden Bush. And starting at forward for the Washington Warriors, a 6'7" senior, number 34, Cole Benson. The assistant coaches for the Huron Tigers are Bob DeBoer, John Scouten, and Eric Hall. Assistant coaches for the Washington Warriors are Tim Reck, Michael Holstein, J.J. Hayden, and Jeff Tobin. Head coach of the Huron Tigers is Tim Buttenhagen. Head coach of the Washington Warriors is Craig Nelson. Our officials are Andy Deinert, Mike Mutter, and Luke Langer. Alternate official is Eric Donut.
And so we are set to go. Our first game of a state championship in the Denny Sanford Premier Center in Sioux Falls.
Shot there of Tim Buttenhagen. Tim's been longtime coach, of course, did the girls at one time when the girls played in the fall.
And he has been successful no matter who he's been coaching. Ball in the air, Dengu will control, and the Warriors with the ball to start. Huron coming out in a straight-up man-to-man.
Huron had to decide, were they going to take out the inside or are they going to take out the outside? They're going to focus on Goo and Benson. Let Washington shoot from the outside.
Ty Smith will reverse it over to Saganos. Jumper in the corner, up no good by Keller. Rebound, Goo, put back, no, and the rebound pulled down by the Huron Tigers. And quickly ahead comes Hayden Bush.
Look for Bush. He's going to be their key. He's their leading scorer for the Tigers.
Rebound controlled and quickly the other way. Smith cut off along the baseline, reverses it back. Saganos.
Peyton Carr right now on Dengu. Again, they're going to try to collapse on the inside. They don't want Washington to get those two the ball at all. For Huron.
There's a three that was halfway down, but the rebound controlled by Trey Moding. Moding will walk it into the front court.
And Washington using Dengu on Hayden Bush. Bush averaging 16 points a game.
Bush with that left-handed dribble. Goes right side to Peyton Carr. Sam Carr also in the lineup. Moding, shot clock under single digits and a traveling violation. And so turn it back over to the Washington Warriors.
Yeah, I don't think Huron's going to want to get into a running game at all with Washington, Mike.
And I'm going to have to remind myself about that shot clock a couple of times here. Last week, of course, we had the girls B. Right now, Class B does not have a shot clock. So
here comes the trap by the Tigers.
Smith takes it to the baseline, reverses it back to Benson, and out top to Saganos. 35 seconds to shoot is what they have in the AA level. Reverse it, back to Saganos. Saganos, the long jumper, that comes up no good. Rebound, Benson kept it alive and runs it down. Benson, the jumper in the lane, count it, and he'll step to the line. The foul goes on number 20, Sam Carr, the 6'1 junior.
Sam Carr, Peyton Carr, their cousins.
Shot is up and good by Cole Benson. His free throw is good as well. Checking into the lineup now for Huron is Highland Hines. Highland, 5'10", and a sophomore.
And the Warriors bring in Matt Farniak. Farniak is 6'6". And about 280.
Yeah, thereabouts.
He's first... plays a big part of the football program at Washington.
Ball tipped out of bounds by the Warriors. Will stay with Huron as Hayden Bush will inbound against full court trap pressure. Ball tipped away. Saganos puts it up. No good. Goo with the rebound. He'll kick it back out to Benson. Now they'll set the offense. Sam Saganos. Dengu faces up.
Heading off of Goo's leg.
Picked up alertly by Bush and then blocked by Goo.
There's a little length there.
Take a look. Dengu is heading off to play at North Dakota State University next year. Carter Brotherton will check into the lineup for Huron. Also in is number 40. That's Ty Evers, 6'5", and a sophomore. So Huron basketball underneath their own bucket. Again, straight man-to-man by the Washington Warriors. The three on the left wing, up and good. Count it for Ty Evers. The 6'5 sophomore comes off the bench.
Well, that was a nice stroke from the wing, left wide open. That's what Huron has to do if they want to stay in this game. Hit the threes from the outside.
Ty Smith back out to Saganos. Saganos, the junior guard. To Dengu. Crossover. He'll drive to the baseline. The reverse. Count it.
So athletic.
That's what he's gotten so adept at, Craig, the last couple of years as the game has come to him, and he's one of those with huge upside. The steal by Saganos in the backcourt. Tries to hit Farniak. He does, and Farniak gathers and scores. Farniak bobbled it for a moment. Into the front court comes Brotherton. He'll leave it back for Bush, partially blocked. Shot up and a foul whistled. Foul is going to go on Matt Farniok, and we'll step aside. You're watching the boys' Class AA tournament from the Premier Center in Sioux Falls. We're back after this on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. The Warriors, the top seed in this tournament, out to the four-point lead early on the Huron Tigers. So a shot at Craig Nelson of the Warriors.
Third year with the Warriors. Came over from the Brandon Valley coaching staff there, Brett Deckert.
One of the folks that is off of the Don Meyer coaching tree up at Northern State University. Huron, shot blocked by Benson. Here comes Smith. Huron is back quickly, but Smith pulls up and buries the 15-footer.
Yeah, Ty Smith pretty much beating Huron back. Anytime Washington gets the ball, Huron's got to get back quickly because Washington will try to up-tempo.
Ty Evers comes into the front court. Now they'll leave it for Hayden Bush. Work that perimeter. As Hines with the ball gives it up to Bush. Or to Peyton Carr, excuse me. Now Bush with the ball, covered by Goo.
That's a good matchup.
Tries to use the high screen, lost the handle. Saganos clears it. Smith to Goo. Bounce pass, he probably should have gone high with that one rather than the bounce pass.
Or just take it in himself.
Yep.
Good defense by Huron.
It was, yep. They did a nice job of cluttering that up. But it will stay with the Washington Warriors. Back into the lineup, or into the lineup. First time is Greg Conrad. 6'1 junior for Huron. Smith to Goo. Keller, Saganos. Reverse it back to Keller. He thought about it.
Warriors are 4 of 9 shooting, 0 of 2 from the arc.
Benson in the lane, puts it up. Goo couldn't save it. His foot was on the line. And it will turn back over to Huron, but this will give Washington an opportunity to set up their press. Hayden Bush will inbound. Ty Evers, double team, got it off to Bush. Pass up ahead.
Nice.
Nice job of breaking the pressure and drawing the foul from Benson. Going to the line is Highland Hines, the 5'10 sophomore.
Tigers were patient, got through that press. Nice pass on the entry. Down low to Highland Hines.
Yep, they turned it into a nice 3-on-2. Got that one.
Huron will go 9, maybe 10 deep as you see Craig Nelson.
Yeah, they've already gone 9. That's up and good as well. A nice job by Hines of converting at the free throw line.
These two teams did not play each other during the regular season.
Goo will take the jump shot. Nice rebound pulled down by Bush. Bush will try to answer the other way. Up, no good.
Oops.
Rebound foul going to be whistled. I think number 30 had a hold. He did. Greg Conrad, the 6'1 junior, whistled for the foul. And now Huron coming out in pressure. Keller all the way to the basket. Puts it up, no good, but he's fouled.
Yeah, Evers will pick up the foul there. It's going to be the third team foul, the first on Evers.
So stepping up to the free throw line is Carter Keller.
43% shooter. And with that 10th point, the Washington student section starts going nuts.
It's very funny. Both these teams school, their colors are black and orange. Free throw is no good, but Saganos with the rebound. Reverse it. Saganos, corner, too strong. Rebound controlled by Peyton Carr. Both these teams are black and orange, but today the Washington student section declared it USA Day for their choice of dress. So their desk decked out in red, white, and blue. Peyton Carr over on the right side, no good. Carter Brotherton couldn't get it to fall quickly the other way. Keller tries to leave it for Benson, knocked out of bounds.
Sam Carr back in for the Tigers. Washington is the taller team on the court right now, Mike. They've had it's going to be tough for them to try to go down in the lane. So it's very important for the Tigers to get some pretty good outside shooting.
Into the front court comes Peyton Carr. Bush will take it, no good. Nice rebound inside, double pump, and one. Count it.
Beautiful. What a nice job. Hyland Hines used his body, Mike. He knew Dango was all over him, so he kind of stepped back a little bit and drew the foul and gets the bucket.
Nice job by the sophomore. Got that one, a three-point play. And checking into the lineup now is 22, Staley. So 10 players have seen action for Huron in this first quarter. Benson picked up his dribble, leaves it for Siganos. Into the front court, again, man-to-man defense being played by Huron. Ty Smith. Reminder that the Class B tournament and the Class A tournament also being brought to you in their entirety on SDPB 2 and 3. And you can always log on to sdpb.org. Shot clock at 3. Siganos banks it in.
His 15th of the year. A dramatic one at the state tournament.
A good defensive stand by Huron there, but then the long three the other way. That one comes up short. The long rebound goes to Benson.
Huron 1-for-6 from the three-point arc.
Quickly ahead, there's Keller. He'll put it on the floor. Drive into the lane, find the trailer. That's Benson, and Benson is fouled. Peyton Carr will pick up the foul.
Tigers did a pretty good job of collapsing the defense. They're trying not to allow any penetration in the lane.
Jacob Johnson, 6'1 and a senior, will check in for the first time for the Washington Warriors. He comes in and Carter Keller takes a seat. Siganos to Benson. Benson, reverse, count it.
That's 6'7 length, long arms, reverse layup. Pretty nice looking reverse layup.
And a traveling violation forced on Sam Carr in the backcourt. Sam had an angle for a moment on a pass. The angle closed, and he is called for traveling. Keller checks back in. Jacob Johnson takes a seat. Siganos now, shot clock is off.
Look for a layup.
Dengu. Ty Smith. To Keller. You see the time winding down in the quarter. Siganos now will reset.
Sam Carr fronting Benson. Peyton Carr fronting Gu.
Siganos, fall away, no. Rebound controlled by Huron. Do they get it off? They get it in time, no. And so at the end of one, Sioux Falls, Washington with the 7-point lead. We're back to the Premier Center after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. Huron will have the ball to start the second quarter. There you got a look at the Sioux Falls, Washington student section. A good turnout from the student section today.
In that first period, Huron 2-for-10 from the floor, 1-of-6 beyond the arc, 3-for-3 from the free throw line.
Highland Hines really provided them a spark off the bench. Peyton Carr goes over to Trey Moding. Moding is going to be fouled, and that's going to go on Carter Keller.
That'll be his first.
And that is the fourth team foul on Washington.
See if the Tigers try to challenge in the paint. A lot of their shots have come from outside. Well, they tried to challenge that time.
Up ahead to Goo, and it's intercepted by Moding. Moding off to Sam Carr. To cousin Peyton Carr. Houston Hines. To Highland Hines. Ball thrown into the backcourt. It was tipped. Washington. Yep, it will belong to Huron. The ball was tipped, and I wasn't just sure if Hayden Butch realized that or not. But he did let it go out of bounds, which was a good decision on his part. However, the shot clock does not reset. So now 10 seconds on the shot clock.
Oops.
Whoa! And a traveling violation. Peyton Carr came to the hard stop. You're just happy to see him pop up so quickly there.
They're going to bring in Evers to give Peyton a little chance to test out the foot, make sure he's okay.
Into the front court. Here come the Warriors. Cross court. Ty Smith back to Benson. Keller in the corner. Zaganos to Smith. He'll take the three. No good. Good job of boxing out down low.
Huron has out-rebounded Washington 10-8.
Sam Carr is only 6'1", but he did a great job there with position. Ball tipped away from Evers. Up ahead. Up and good for Carter Keller.
Using the glass, hitting the basket.
Full court pressure once again. Huron successfully breaks it, gets a left-handed layup from Hayden Bush.
Leading scorer gets his first points of the game for the Tigers.
Baseline jumper put up by Smith, no good. Strong rebound muscled down by Evers. The bounce pass is stolen by Benson.
Well, that's the ninth turnover of the game for the Tigers.
Into the front court, Sam Zaganos, 6'1 junior.
Boy, Tigers working hard defensively and bringing a lot of changes in almost every dead ball, trying to keep everybody fresh defensively.
Benson double-teamed and had the ball stolen. Into the front court comes Huron. Cross court. Hines for three. The sophomore, Highland Hines.
That was an NBA three.
In transition, did a nice job. Shot is up from the corner as Keller tries to answer. No good. Coming the other way. Ball stolen, loose on the floor. Benson comes up with it. 10 turnovers now for Huron. Benson, Zaganos. The drive, and he is fouled. He'll step to the line and shoot two. Stepping up to the free throw line is Sam Zaganos. That one no good. As a raft of players check in. Everybody kind of getting used to the new joint here. We had a bunch of players check in with us right there.
We can't do anything about that.
Nope, we're trying to figure out the angles on where we can see the scoreboards. Everything a little bit new. Got that one, and we'll step aside. You're watching the South Dakota Boys AA Championships on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. With Craig Maddock from Sioux Falls Sports Radio, I'm Mike Henriksen from Sports Max and Calling All Sports. You can follow all three basketball tourneys on your mobile device. Updates on all high school championship events on Facebook and Twitter as well.
Hey, let's find out where you're watching, too. Let us know on Twitter, Facebook, where you're watching here this afternoon.
Huron. Switch defense here by the Warriors. Matt Farniok back in the lineup.
Huron has only shot the ball three times from inside the three-point arc.
Peyton Carr. Shot clock now at 8. Jumper out top. Up and good for 3. This time it's Hyland Hines.
Hyland. Second 3 of the game.
Yeah, he's got 8 points. Nice spark off the bench.
Huron had that 7-point deficit.
Oh, yeah, oh, yeah, oh, yeah.
Ball picked off to the rack. Layup, up, no good. Rebound, though, pulled out by Hines.
Good job by challenging to the rack and then taking it back out when nothing was there.
Shot put up, no good. Oh. You are not going to run over Matt Farniok. And he's not going to flop on you either. Quinton Jones is in the lineup now for the Warriors. He was the player that took the tumble down on the other end.
Warriors are 7 of 19 shooting, 1 of 6 beyond the arc.
That's Jones. Now Saganos with the left hand scoring.
Wow, he found a very small seam in that defense.
Here comes Huron the other way. Dish it out. 3 up and good. Hyland Hines. He's got 11. Here come the Warriors. Saganos. That's over the defense. Quinton Jones, and 3-second violation.
You know, it's been a couple of weeks, almost 2 weeks, since these teams have played. You know, that was one of the keys for Craig Nelson of Washington, after not playing for almost 2 weeks. He says they had a 2-week break during the season and said it took about 4 minutes of the first quarter for them to even really get back into the rhythm of the game.
So Huron with the chance to take the lead. The pull-up jumper, no, but stepping to the free throw line will be Peyton Carr.
Well, they're going right to that low block and challenging Farniok.
Shot is up and good. Tie ball game. And the lead for the number 8 seed, Huron Tigers. Saganos brings it into the front court. He's met there by Greg Conrad.
Again, the Tigers, their goal defensively was to clog up the middle and let Washington shoot from the outside.
Keller, Benson. Ty Smith, double teamed. Keller, 3. Lead back to the Huron Tigers. Greg Conrad, Matt Farniok got a little tangled up on that non-rebound. There's a drive, left hand, no good. Smith with the rebound. 3, yes.
Boy, Saganos hits his second 3 straight on.
The lead was short-lived for the Huron Tigers. Back-to-back threes have the Warriors up by five. There's a three as Huron tries to answer, and a reach-in foul going on Carter Brotherton. That is the sixth team foul, so still not in the bonus. Houston Hines will check into the lineup now for Huron. Farniak takes a seat for Washington. Deng Gu, spin, spun right into the defense, the loose ball, Cole Benson is there to put it up and score it. So an 8-0 run since Huron took that lead. Right side, they'll go to Highland Hines in the drive and a foul. That goes on number 20, Carter Keller. That is his second personal foul. That is the sixth team foul on Washington. Highland Hines looking to add to his 11-point total in this first half. Got it. Both 13 and a half off the bench. Back into the lineup is Trey Moding. Moding comes in, and Bush will take a seat for the Tigers. See if the Warriors go for the last shot here. Up ahead to Benson. And Saganos will set the offense. He's guarded out there by Moding. See the time winding away. Gu and Smith. Now, back it goes. Saganos with seven. He'll set, use the screen set by Gu. Tries for the pick and roll. The three at the buzzer, no good. And that's how we wrap up this first half of action. The Huron boys had taken the 21-20 lead. And Craig Maddock is standing by with the head coach at Washington.
Coach, your reaction first half? That was an up-and-down first half, wasn't it?
About what I expected. I knew that they'd come out and play extremely hard and really intense, and thought we were a little bit tight, not just taking the open jump shots when we had them and things like that. And just got to play a little bit more loose in the second half.
Looks like Huron defensively trying to bottle up that paint.
Exactly what we thought, exactly like what teams have been doing the last half of the season.
Coach, good luck.
Thanks. Thank you.
Craig Nielsen, head coach of the Washington Warriors. We're at halftime. AA Boys Basketball Tournament here in South Dakota Public Broadcast.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
From the Premier Center in Sioux Falls, South Dakota, it is the boys' Class AA Championships. Breaking in a new facility this year, after saying goodbye to the championship game in the Sioux Falls Arena with Class A last year. Good look at Huron Tiger fans. Pretty good turnout for a Thursday afternoon. Coming up next, we've got Rapid City taking on Aberdeen Central. With Craig Maddock from Sioux Falls Sports Radio, KWSN, I'm Mike Henriksen from SportsMax and Calling All Sports. Let's take a look at some first half highlights. It was a back and forth game. Washington got out to a 15-8 lead in that first quarter. But Huron battled their way back. They took a 21-20 lead. There's a nice shot up and good by Keller, but Huron comes back to answer. Houston Hines with the three. Saganos with the drive off the glass with the left hand. Coming back, there's Saganos again, this time with the three. The long jumper on the way out on the wing. Inside, Cole Benson able to score. But Huron battled back on the strength of Highland Hines, the 5'10 sophomore, came off the bench, and he had 13 total points. There you see some of the Washington fans. Again, they designated today as USA Day, as the way that they were dressing up. With Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen. Craig, taking a look, any stats that jump out at you right away?
Well, the Washington Warriors, they have the bigger club on the floor. When you got Goo at 6'8", Benson at 6'7", and Huron, their biggest is 6'4", maybe 6'5". They have out-rebounded the Warriors in that first half, 13-10. And I know Huron, they wanted to clog up the middle, and so far they've done that pretty well. But the outside shooting for Huron was not too bad. 4 of 10. You know they're going to be shooting a little more from the outside, but they were 4 of 10 from the three-point arc in that first half.
They started having some success once they started taking better care of the basketball. They had 10 turnovers early in the game, but they finished the half with just 11. So they did a much better job of dealing with the pressure of Washington, and that's what got them back into it. We are at halftime. There you see the stats. Huron with just 17 shots that they were able to attempt. Washington got off 24. Huron, as Craig mentioned, 4 of 10 from three-point range. And you see the 11 turnovers as well. That pressure defense for Huron, pretty effective. We'll be back to the Premier Center. The second half of action still to come. The one in the eighth seed. A tight one at halftime, 28-23. We're back with more after this on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Championship event is brought to you in part by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Farmers Union Insurance, by SDN Communications, and by the Independent Insurance Agents of South Dakota.
Here with Coach Buttonhagen of the Huron Tigers. Coach, your reaction to that first half. It was a quick tempo type game. Did you like that?
Yeah, we did. Obviously, we got to spread them out. Otherwise, they're too big for us inside, and we got to shoot the ball well and not turn it over.
Trying to keep the paint pretty much covered by you guys defensively.
We are. We're trying. You know, they're the number one seed, so hopefully they're a little tighter and the shots don't flow as easy. But they hit a couple. Paint shot was huge for them. So we got to try to keep the paint plugged and make them shoot from the outside.
All right, Coach. Thanks.
Thank you.
Head Coach Tim Buttonhagen of the Huron Tigers. Mike, we heard about they're going to plug up the middle and try to make the shots from the outside.
While we've got a moment, let's remind you that you can check out the website at sdpb.org/basketball. Find updated brackets and statistics, photos from all of the venues, archives of the games, and more. Stop by sdpb.org. In that first half, 10 players saw action for the Huron Tigers. Limited action for a couple of guys off the bench. Basically a six-person rotation for Washington. Huron comes in 8-15 on the year. Washington at 20-2, undefeated by any South Dakota teams. They lost to two teams from Minnesota. And so it will be Washington Warrior basketball to start the second half. Both teams going with their original starting five. For Huron, Houston Hines, Trey Moding, Sam Carr, Peyton Carr, and Hayden Bush. Saganos, Keller, Smith, Goo, and Benson. Benson reverses it to Keller. Keller thought about the three, drives instead, and scores it.
He's got 8 points. Huron has not scored a field goal since 2:49 to go in the first half.
Now remember, they led it 21-20. Kick it back outside to Hayden Bush, who has been quiet offensively. Hines for three, no good. Good rebound, Peyton Carr. He'll spin back in against Benson, and he is fouled.
Yeah, good job by Carr going and challenging Benson. Hines going to the line. And that's Benson's second foul.
Peyton Carr will step to the free throw line.
It's two for two today.
Got that one, Peyton Carr.
Well, and Huron is 8 for 8 from that free throw line.
They need to take advantage of every situation. A good trip there for Huron.
Let's see what Smith. Washington does. Washington knows they're going to be collapsing in the paint. See if they're going to try to challenge. Look for Dangu or Benson.
Smith, right side, Keller, three.
That's his second of the game. He's got 11.
Carter Keller swells that lead. Loading. Picked up by Keller. Off to Bush. To Peyton Carr. He'll face up. Jumper no good. Weak side rebound. Tipped around, and Smith comes out of there with it. Smith double team, picked up his dribble, reverses it to Keller. He thought about the three. Spins, gives it back out to Siganos. Benson triple teamed on the low post. He'll reverse it to Keller for three. Got it. Back-to-back threes by Carter Keller. Biggest lead of the game for the Washington Warriors. Carr. Siganos comes over on the switch. Foul whistled. That's going to go on Carter Keller, and he knew it the minute he did it.
That'll be his second. Both teams are finding out that it's been pretty tough to go down the lane. So tough, kind of like going down 41st Street on a Saturday afternoon. A lot of traffic, not a lot to get through.
Bush gives it up to Carr. Jumper in the lane. Oh, was halfway down, wouldn't go, and Benson muscles down the rebound. Up ahead to Keller. Keller will drive. Reverse it, one extra pass. Benson in the lane, no, but he'll go to the line and shoot two. Foul is going to go on Houston Hines. Benson, got it. We talked about Cole Benson. Big sister Ellie won a state title for those Sioux Falls, Washington girls last year. Cole's mom is Joelle Byrie. You may remember that name from the
Hall of Famer.
Yep, from the outstanding Washington teams. And I was trying to figure out how to phrase that. We'll just go with the early days of girls basketball in the state of South Dakota.
Joelle won't mind.
No, she won't. Tigers in need of a bucket. On the low block, it goes to Evers. Nice little jump hook. Evers with a big basket. Again, reminder that Huron led this 21-20. The other way, Keller with the reverse on the left hand.
Keller only averages 8 points a game. He's got 16 today. Beautiful reverse layup.
Ball tipped, it went off of a Huron player, and it goes out of bounds, over and back. We'll step aside. You're watching the boys' AA state championship on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. With Craig Metnick, I'm Mike Henriksen from the Premier Center. The first ever state tournament basketball game here in this brand new facility.
And a shot there of the Washington Warrior head coach, Craig Nelson, in his third year.
Reverse it. Inside, Benson puts it up. Won't go. Rebound to the Huron Tigers. Here comes Hayden Bush looking to cut into this lead. Off to Evers. Back out it goes to Trey Moding. Moding, the 5'11 junior. Pull-up jumper by Evers, up and good.
It's the second one of the day, Mike. He's got 8 points.
Quickly, the other way. Jumper by Smith, no good. And the rebound controlled by Moding. Huron cutting into this lead. Back it goes to Highland Hines, the sophomore who came off that bench to score 13 in the first half. Bush gives it up to Carr. Peyton and Sam Carr are cousins. There's a drive by Moding with single digits on the clock, up and good.
What a great drive. Just kept going around in the circle and found the seam. I don't think Craig Nelson liked that last basket.
The drive by Benson, left hand and one.
Well, it was Benson who found the little seam coming down the lane.
And back to Benson, not only is he the son of Joe Albiri, the former Joe Albiri, he essentially had both of his knees replaced when he was in junior high, and not with mechanical knees. He had to go to the Mayo Clinic where they put in new tissue, essentially the bones. My understanding of being a doctor, I'll give you the basic on this. The bones and the cartilage just weren't growing. They were dead. And so he was in a wheelchair for much of junior high. By the time he was a freshman, he started playing a little more basketball. He's also a pretty good tennis player. And
got a little blood time here, by the way. Sam Sagano's a little blood there working on him around the sideline. And they get that wrapped up. So that's going to help our knees then, Mike. Is that what
you're
saying?
Right. Well, no, we'll get the fake knees when it's time for us. But it was great because it allowed him to keep growing. Now 6'7" and a senior. It's up, no good, but Smith with the rebound and the putback.
His second basket of the game.
43-32. Huron had gotten it close, or cut into the lead anyway, but the Warriors answer. There's a nice drive by Hines, and he is fouled.
Matt Farniak going to get the blocking foul. That would be his second. I like the job of the Tigers attacking to the low block, challenging the Warriors.
So stepping up to the free throw line is Highland Hines.
5 for 5 from the line. Here comes Dengu back in. Dengu, the leading scorer, only 2 points on the day.
Yeah, he has been very quiet offensively. And Cole Benson will take a seat. It's up and good. 15 off the bench for the sophomore. Saganos, the hesitation, feeds Farniak for the finger roll layup.
And you have a guy like Farniak with his size able to come off the bench, play a big part in the paint. That's a big plus for Washington.
Yeah, he sealed his man off perfectly. Three put up, no good. Rebound by Ty Smith. Smith into the front court, leaves it for Saganos. Goo, no good. Farniak kept it alive. Farniak up one more time, and he is fouled. He'll step to the line to shoot two. If you wonder why big-time Division I colleges are recruiting Matt Farniak, that's a prime example. 6'6", in the neighborhood of 270 or so.
On the footwork there.
Yeah, exactly. That's the thing. He's got the quickness and the footwork. One of the reasons he still plays basketball, his big brothers who are at Iowa State and Oklahoma playing offensive line. Neither of them, they both gave it up about their sophomore year or so, didn't they, Craig?
They love playing football on the basketball court.
Right.
They were physical and they were fun to watch.
Shot no good and the rebound controlled by Huron.
Just because you're big doesn't necessarily mean you got what it takes, though, to be on the court.
True.
But they're thriving as college football players.
Huron. That's Houston Hines. Dengu made him change the shot, but a foul going to be whistled.
Yeah, this might go on Farnia.
Yep. Matt will pick up his third personal foul.
Well, that means Benson's going to come back in. You don't want Farniak to get four here before the quarter is up.
Carter Brotherton will step up to the free throw line. First shot is up and good.
Don't want to jinx him, but Huron has not missed a free throw today. They've been excellent from that line. 12 of 12.
Shot no good.
Sorry.
Yep. There was the jinx.
Oh, no way. Dengu was surrounded, and they're going to give this one on Peyton Carr.
For Carr, that will be his second, and that is the fourth team foul.
And nobody in foul trouble on for the Huron Tigers.
Shot put up no good by Carter Keller.
Yeah, but then Farniak gave it right to Brotherton.
The drive by Carr, partially blocked by Saganos, but he was out of bounds when he next touched the ball. So leave it for Huron. By the way, a couple of pretty talented assistant coaches for these staffs, too. Eric Hall, who was about as good a player as Huron has ever turned out.
Yeah, that was 2004, Mike.
Is that what it was?
Won the title.
Yeah, he's an assistant on Tim Budenhagen's staff. Stepping to the free throw line will be Peyton Carr. J.J. Hayden, I believe he won a title with Washington, too, didn't he?
That
right around 2000?
Was, I believe, 03.
03? Okay. Yeah.
And then, of course, he went down to Mont Marty and played.
Right.
Collegiately.
Eric with the nice career at the University of South Dakota. Nice little jump hook. Wouldn't fall, but Huron with the another rebound.
Tigers have really out-rebounded the Warriors, even though they're the smaller team on the floor. 22 to 16.
Pull-up jumper by Evers. No good. Rebound run down once again. This time, Houston Hines. And Brotherton will set the offense. Brings it back out top, and then a miscue. Turn it back over to the Washington Warriors.
It's only the second turnover of the second half for Huron.
Yeah, they started off rough. They had 10 turnovers early, but they have taken much better care of the basketball since that time.
Let's see if the Warriors try to go to Dengu. They haven't really tried to go to him very often. Look for number 32. See if they try to go to him, but he's surrounded by four Tigers right now.
Ty Smith works the perimeter. Dengu out top. Back to Smith. Down low, they try to get it inside, and it's tipped away from Benson. Here comes Huron. Carr. Peyton Carr. To Houston Hines. He got it off to Carr before committing the travel. The three on the way, up and good by Sam Carr.
That's his first basket of the game.
Saganos, pull up, good if it goes. Oh, was halfway down at the end of three complete. The number 18 here on Tigers. Hanging around. Washington with the lead, and we're back after this timeout on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. With Craig Maddock from Sioux Falls Sports Radio, KWSN, I'm Mike Henriksen from Calling All Sports and Sports Max. Three quarters down. First game of the 2015 Boys AA Tournament from the new Denny Sanford Premier Center in Sioux Falls.
Here's the Huron numbers. They're 10 of 29 from the floor.
Ball loose, stolen away. Dengu, the run out. The spin, no good. Rebound, knocked out of bounds. It will stay with the Warriors.
Pretty good defense by Peyton Carr. He's staying with Gu the whole way. Here are the Washington numbers through three quarters. 18 of 36 from the floor. 5 of 13 from the three-point arc.
Siganos goes off to Keller, and a foul whistled underneath. That is going to go on Sam Carr.
It's going to Sam, be his second.
Yep, Sam was matched up on the 6'8 Dengu. Ends up getting called for the hold. Inbound to Cole Benson, who's back in the lineup. Benson puts it up, no good, and he'll step to the line and shoot two.
Well, Peyton Carr has just picked up his third foul. And the Tigers need Peyton Carr out there on the court for his size.
Cole Benson with 10 points on the afternoon. 11.
He is 3-4-5 from the line. Shot again at Craig Nelson of the Warriors.
Got them both. Back up to a 9-point lead. Loading front court. Uses the screen. Gets it off to Hayden Bush.
That was partially deflected.
Hayden Bush has been quiet offensively today. Up ahead to Siganos. He'll leave it for Smith for three. Short. Rebound Moting. Moting up ahead to Bush. Reverse it. It's Peyton Carr. Drive with the left hand by Peyton, no good. Tipped and controlled by the Warriors, and then a reach-in foul on Hayden Bush.
It's going to be his second.
And I believe that will be 1-1. It will. That is the seventh team foul on Huron. And so stepping to the free throw line will be Ty Smith.
.59% shooter, Ty Smith. Warriors are now 7 of 13 from the free throw line.
Got that one as well. Every time it feels like Huron is coming back, Washington has answered, just sort of keeping them at arm's length. But a lot of people did not expect Huron to be here. They have represented themselves really well.
They had to beat a very good Aberdeen team at Aberdeen, and then they had to go out to Sturgis, who I thought was going to be here. They had to beat them at Sturgis in the region final.
Jumper on the way, no good. Rebound, a foul whistled, and that's going to go on Carter Keller.
Yeah, that's going to be his third.
That is the sixth team foul on Washington. So from here on out, both teams will be shooting free throws on each foul. Checking back into the lineup is Jacob Johnson. Jacob saw approximately 12 seconds worth of action in that first half. And a 5-second violation whistled. Warriors didn't allow Huron to get the ball in. Turn it back over to Washington. Again, if you're not familiar with our format on South Dakota Public Broadcasting, all 12 games from all three locations.
Come on, get a stop now.
Class A tournament going on out in the beautiful Black Hills in South Dakota. And the B should be good numbers at that tournament up in Aberdeen.
Huron has done a pretty good job today of keeping a lot of that traffic out of the way in the paint.
Goo had the ball stripped up ahead to Bush. Cross court, Hines, pull up jumper, fouled. He'll go to the line and shoot two. Highland Hines, 5'10 and a sophomore. He has 15 points, including 13 in that first half. Provided a great spark when he came in for Coach Tim Budenhagen.
It's
Checking back into the lineup, Carter Brotherton. Rebound by Dengu. Ty Smith thought about the three. Gu.
Well, that defense collapses so quickly on, the, on that low block. Look at three of them right there on Cole Benson.
Puts it up, no good, and the rebound by Evers.
Cole Benson is 4-for-7 shooting. Dengu 1-for-5.
Huron's going to make
go down low.
Huron's going to make some noise here, and Gu will commit the foul, and that will be the 7th team foul. So Huron will be shooting free throws. Huron's going to make some news here down the line. Hayden Bush and Houston Hines are their two seniors that start. Mason Stolle saw a little bit of action in that first half, and Carter Brotherton has been key off the bench, but otherwise, you've got three juniors. You've got Highland Hines, a sophomore, comes off the bench. Ty Evers off the bench. Greg Conrad, another junior, off the bench. Up but no good. And the rebound to Gu.
First free throw missed by Peyton Carr.
Sam Saganos. Up to Ty Smith. Smith gets it back down low. He'll rise up, and he is fouled. Foul is whistled on Hayden Bush. For Hayden, that is his third personal. Up and good. Seven points on the day for Ty Smith. Make it eight and we'll step aside. You're watching the boys' AA tournament on South Dakota Public Broadcasting. The Sioux Falls, Washington cheer section. They chose USA as their dress-up theme today. A good turnout from the Huron Tigers as well. Their student section, they're going with the whiteout this afternoon.
Huron's being led by Highland Hines with 16.
Evers, give it up. Brotherton comes around the corner. Now goes back to Peyton Carr. Evers on the block against Gu. The sophomore goes with the left hand.
Tough to go down inside.
Comes up short, and the Warriors will walk it into the front court. Right side to Carter Keller, who's had himself a terrific game today. Benson. Cross court. Smith. Jumper. Good. Ty Smith with the jumper.
He's got 10.
10 on the afternoon. Weatherton. Senior point guard. On the block, they go to Peyton Carr. Carr rises up, had it partially blocked by Benson. And Smith will bring it into the front court. Go off to Keller, use a screen, a little jumper, up no good. Dengu kept it alive. Keller nearly took a tumble across the bench.
Press row.
Give it back over to Huron. Huron, a comeback to take the lead in the second quarter, 21-20. But then Washington went on an 8-0 run to get that lead back. And they ahead to get Goo layup. What a pass from three-quarter length court from Sam Saganos. Washington has been able to keep Huron at arm's length pretty much ever since. Tigers have had their moments. Ball blocked inside, and I think Goo will be called for the foul. Unless it's going to go on. Nope, it will be on Ding. His third. Ding, a kid who they talk about, has huge upside when it comes to his potential. He's heading off to North Dakota State University next year. Free throw is up and good. As Sam Carr hits that one.
Ty Smith, by the way, has a double-double this afternoon. 10 rebounds, 10 points.
For Sam Carr, he's got 4 points on the day. Goo with the rebound. Smith. Benson.
Nice battle with Evers down low against Goo.
Yeah, that sophomore, it's going to be tough. Evers. Jumper on the wing, no good by Saganos, and a good job by Evers of blocking out so that Sam Carr could get the rebound.
Gets his third rebound of the game.
Sam Corner. Drive in the lane. Pull-up jumper blocked. Carter Keller stayed with it defensively. See if he's rewarded the other end. No, but he is fouled. Foul is going to go on Hayden Bush.
It's going to be number 4 on Bush.
He has been very quiet today with just 2 points for Hayden Bush. A good defensive effort by the Warriors on him.
Team for Carter Keller.
And a timeout going to be called by the Washington Warriors. As you see the time, 2:03 to play, up to a 16-point lead by the Washington Warriors.
We're going to see Rapid City Stevens and Aberdeen Central go at it in the next quarterfinal game.
That should be fun. I'm looking forward to seeing Aberdeen. I have not had the opportunity to see them. I saw Stevens earlier this year.
Going to see one of the top players in AA basketball in Sam McLeod for Rapid City Stevens. He lit it up here in the Denny when they defeated Sioux Falls Lincoln earlier in the season.
You could make an argument for him for player of the year this year, I think.
Yes, you could.
He's been terrific, so... looking forward to that. And, of course, a reminder, we would love to hear from you. Follow us on Twitter at SDPB Sports. You can also find us on Facebook and always online at sdpb.org. Always fascinating to find out where people are watching from across the United States and even overseas. And if you are serving our country overseas, thank you so much. We're glad that we can bring you a taste of South Dakota to wherever you may be. Carter Keller will step in. 17 points on the day. His second free throw is up. No good. And the rebound controlled by Evers. Into the front court. Here comes Trey Moding. Moding gives it up to Highland Hines. Drive by Hines. Couldn't get it to fall, but he was fouled on the drive.
Impressed with Highland Hines, you know, sophomore. Certainly not playing like one.
By the way.
If you like that phrase.
Yep.
Kid that looks pretty poised on the court.
Very much so. By the way, he and Houston Hines, I was just informed, they're the grandsons of Harvey Hammerick of Watertown.
Oh, the old AD of Watertown.
Yeah, I'd seen Harvey here, and I figured, well, sure, he's here to... You know, watch Watertown, but he's front row and center for the Huron game, and that explains it.
Where's he going to sit if Watertown and Huron?
I'm not sure. Coming the other way, the Warriors giving it up.
He can sit by us if he wants.
That's right. We've got a chair. Harvey is always welcome. Cross-court pass as the Warriors try to eat a little time.
Good D.
Tough D by Huron.
Oh, watch out.
And a foul going to be whistled.
Hyland Hines will get that one with the reach in.
And Siganos will step to the line. No, Keller, excuse me. Carter Keller will step to the line to shoot two. Got that one. He's got 18 points on the day.
Averages eight per game.
Both teams have been very effective at the free throw line today. As the clock winds, Siganos tips it away and comes up with the steal.
Now a little keep away for Washington.
Keller.
The bench Siganos is getting cleared.
Benson, the reverse, score it.
He's nice. Had like three reverse layups in
yep.
this game.
Nice patience underneath by the big man.
Both teams emptying the benches.
30-second so I'm going to just basically go through some names here. I just saw Brendan Cohen from Huron check in. Alex Jimenez is in. 34 is Clay Corco. I wonder if his twin brother Cole Corco checked in. I'm looking for number 50. Yep, there he is. And who else we got? 32? Yeah, Riley Gaylor. Riley Gaylor checks in. For Washington, we got 12 and 14. That's Jacob Skolstad and Jack Talley. Got 22, Robert Speaks Jr. Got 14. Oh, that's Jack Talley. I told you about him. Got 40. Alipo Oyulak. Corco. Drive has it tipped out of bounds by Speaks Jr. Did I get everybody? 44. There we go. Sam Gazine is into the lineup as well for the Washington Warriors. The three on the way, up and good. Score it for Riley Gaylor. The 5'10 junior hits the jumper. Speaks Jr. will come into the front court, covered up by a Corco. Back it goes to Gazine. So all these kids getting an opportunity to play in the first ever state tournament basketball game held at the Premier Center in Sioux Falls. As the clock winds down, Talley will dribble it out. And the Sioux Falls Washington Warriors don't let the final score fool you, because Huron hung around for a long time. Washington was challenged, but they're able to pull away in that fourth quarter and pick up the 16-point victory over Huron. Coming up next, of course, we've got Rapid City Stevens and Aberdeen Central. And Craig Maddock, I'm trying to spot Craig. There he is. Okay, now I can actually. There's a lot of news this afternoon as to where to find the scoreboard, where to find the angle, where Maddock is going to be. Now we got him. Craig Maddock is standing by with Craig Nelson.
Coach hadn't played in 2 weeks. Did it look like it today? Or yeah, you got into the rhythm in the second half.
I would say so. I thought we defended pretty well. We allowed a few too many threes and a few offensive rebounds. But outside of that, played pretty well, especially the second half. and find a way to get it done. You know, it's not always going to be pretty. You're not always going to have your best offensive night. You still got to find a way to win those ones.
Carter Keller had a big game, normally averages 18. He was well in the double figures today.
It was great to see him attack the rim and get some easy stuff inside, and then a couple of three-pointers came really easy to him later on because they were trying to pack it inside. So that's a credit to our bigs and teams having to guard us that way, and all of our guards having open looks. Carter did a great job when he drove the ball of getting under control and making those layups.
Coach, congratulations. See you tomorrow night.
Thanks a lot.
It's Coach Craig Nelson of the Washington Warriors as they advance to the semifinals tomorrow night. And we've got more of the AA Boys Basketball Tournament from the Denny Sanford Premier Center in Sioux Falls coming up on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Sports Championship is underwritten by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Mid-Continent Communications, and by Dakota Bank.
With Craig Maddock, I'm Mike Henriksen. The Sioux Falls Washington Warriors pick up the first round victory over the Huron Tigers today as Washington ends up with the 16-point lead. But again, it was tighter than that. And Craig, let's take a look at some of the highlights of that first half, or of the second half.
Jumper. Warriors hitting it from the outside. They got a big game today from a couple of their guard play.
Yep.
Carter Keller and Ty Smith.
Moting answered. A nice shot there of the Huron crowd. Farniok. Jumper by Ty Smith. Loosen things up a little bit. Dengu with the beautiful pass from Siganos. The patience in the lane, but then the block by Keller coming the other way. Benson puts it up, scores it, and then the three up and good for Riley Gaylor off the bench in the late going of that tournament, or of that game. And
double, so, double for Ty Smith today. 10 boards, 10 points.
You see Washington got off 44 shots. Huron 7 for 16 at 3, but again, Huron against a much bigger Sioux Falls Washington team.
Out-rebounded.
Out-rebounds
yes.
Washington.
Huron was led by Hyland Hines, 17 points.
And that was off the bench. He did not start today, the sophomore, with 13 of those in the first half. And you see Huron, they got off to a rough start. They were turning the ball over. They had 10 turnovers about halfway through that second quarter.
They had a dozen in the first half, only
right.
Four in the second.
Exactly. Did a much better job. And again, for a 1-8 seed, that was a good opening round game here of the boys' AA tournament. So coming up, we'll get you set for our second game of the day as the Aberdeen Central Golden Eagles will be taking on the Rapid City Stevens Raiders. You're watching the South Dakota Class AA Boys Basketball Tournament from the Denny Sanford Premier Center in Sioux Falls on South Dakota Public Broadcasting.
Free statewide broadcast of this South Dakota High School Championship event is brought to you in part by the thousands of members of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, by Farmers Union Insurance, by SDN Communications, and by the Independent Insurance Agents of South Dakota.